graduation ceremony for the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industry and the Faculty of Law at the University of Auckland. Our official proceedings will begin very shortly. In a moment, your graduands will enter the auditorium and I shall invite you to stand. They will then be followed by their academics and by our official party. As the official party enters, we invite you to join the singing of the traditional graduation song, Gaudiamus. Please then take your seat as the Chancellor takes his seat. If you're carrying a cell phone, ensure it's either turned off or made silent. And whilst you're very welcome to take photographs, please move back to your seat immediately afterwards. And please don't stand in the aisles. At the end of the ceremony, the Chancellor will invite you all to sing God Defend New Zealand for the first time with your new graduates. Please remain standing following the end of the anthem as the processions leave the auditorium. Once the last graduates have left, you will also be invited to leave. Ladies and gentlemen, would you all please stand?
Thank you. Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga hoe fa. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou. Tēnā koutou katoa. Vice Chancellor, Pro Chancellor, Council members, special guests, staff, graduands, family and friends of graduands. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of Council members and staff of the University. In particular, I welcome our guest speaker, Sir Anand Satyanand. I also acknowledge the recent passing of Dr. Merimere Penfold, who was a long-term member of the University of Auckland staff, a distinguished Māori scholar, and for many years, the kuia at our graduation ceremonies. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland for the purpose of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. This week, we will be conferring and awarding more than 6,572 qualifications on some 6,478 students in person and in absentia. At this ceremony, 512 students will graduate in person and 90 students will graduate in absentia. I will be assisted by Mr. Peter Kiley, the Pro-Chancellor. This is a happy and memorable occasion for you, the graduands, as well as your families and friends who have supported you during your studies. We congratulate you all. Equally, your achievement brings pleasure and satisfaction to the academic and professional staff of the university who have played their part in your success. Capping is a time for celebration. The graduation procession today brought academic flavour and colour to the streets of Auckland, and in this ceremony, you will experience the pomp and tradition befitting your well-deserved day of celebration. Over a period of 130 years, the University of Auckland has become a comprehensive, research-led university with a strong international reputation. Today, there are more than 40,000 students and 5,000 staff. Moreover, we are New Zealand's largest research organisation with one-third of the country's externally rated, world-class researchers. Within New Zealand, only our university is ranked within the top 1% of the world's universities. We also have a strong commitment to Māori education. Of all the Māori degree graduates in New Zealand each year, 25% come from just one institution, the University of Auckland. For Pacifica graduates, the number is close to 40%. The quality and international reputation of a university are fundamentally driven by the achievements of its people, and last year was an exceptional one for our academic staff who won almost every form of recognition available to them in New Zealand. In July, Professor Alison Jones and Associate Professors Bryony James and Katha Simpson won the National Tertiary Teaching Excellence Awards for sustained excellence in tertiary teaching. These awards mean that for the last 11 of the last 12 years, our teachers have been recognised as among the very best in the country. In November, engineers, Distinguished Emeritus Professor John Boyes and Professor Grant Kovic won the Supreme Award at the Prime Minister's Science Prizes Awards for their work on inductive power transfer. Dr. Ben O'Brien from the Auckland Bioengineering Institute won the McDiarmid Emerging Scientist Prize for his groundbreaking work on artificial muscles. And Dr. Susie Wiles from Molecular Medicine and Pathology won the Science Media Communication Prize. Our staff also excelled at the 2013 Royal Society of New Zealand Awards, winning 4 major medals. The most notable was Distinguished Professor Dame Anne Salmon from Māori Studies, winning the Society's highest honour, the Rutherford Medal. This was awarded for her eminent work on Māori social structures and interactions within the European world and on European exploration in the Pacific. She was also named Kiwi Bank New Zealand of the Year for 2013. These achievements reflect the outstanding quality not only of our academic staff, but also of the students who work with them and the many professional staff who support them. A key part of our challenge for the future, and one that is clearly reflected in our strategic plan, is to continue to invest in a community of highly accomplished staff and students. An important element of that investment is ensuring that our teaching facilities are of the highest quality. To this end, Council completed in 2013 the purchase of the former Lion Breweries site in Newmarket as the basis for a new campus, which will be integrated with the existing City and Grafton campuses. At Newmarket, work is well underway on construction of the engineering research laboratories. These buildings represent an investment of approximately $88 million to support our engineering research and postgraduate teaching for the benefit of all New Zealand. We will occupy the first of the new facilities in July this year. Work has also begun on the new Science Tower on the corner of Wellesley and Simon Streets. This major construction project represents an investment of more than $300 million. It will allow us to upgrade science teaching and research and integrate the School of Psychology and the School of Environment into the main science precinct. This will in turn free up the Human Sciences Building for refurbishment as the centre of the arts faculty. Constant innovation is the cornerstone of a university such as ours. Innovative teaching and research is vital for long-term, sustainable economic growth of our country and social cohesion of our nation. This has never been more so than in the testing times we face in the wake of the global recession, the Christchurch earthquakes, and the yet-to-be-defined effects of global warming. Universities equip graduates like you, not simply for the jobs of today, but for future careers not yet imagined in an ever-changing world. So as you graduate today, please reflect on ongoing learning opportunities and consider the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. Reflect on the changes in technology you have already experienced in your lifetime, and remember that most of the technology you will use in your future working career has yet to be developed or commercialised. I ask you to do this because we can never rest on our laurels, especially in a challenging and ever-changing world. Whatever path you follow as you go out into the world, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. Funding constraints are a perennial problem for New Zealand universities, who are being asked to do more and more with less and less each year. In fact, we should be spending more on universities, not less. So don't worry, we will be in touch with you. And when we do, please lend us your support. But that is enough of the substantial issues facing all of us as members of a 21st century university with high aspirations. Because today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. I am proud to introduce our speaker, Sir Anand Satyanand, who is probably best known for his five-year term as New Zealand's first Governor-General of Indian and Pacific ancestry. Sir Anand is also an alumnus of the University of Auckland, where he obtained his bachelor's degree in law, and where he now serves as a visiting fellow at the Auckland Law School. In this capacity, Sir Anand visits the school regularly so that he's able to speak to and counsel students, offering guidance to those who may be experiencing difficulties. He was awarded a Doctorate of Law, honoris causa, by this university in 2006, the same year in which he began his term as our Governor General. Sir Anand is a proud Aucklander who has spent most of his life here, apart from 20 years in Wellington, although he tells me he commutes between the two cities, where he served two terms as Ombudsman and one as the nation's 19th representative of the Queen. So Anand, we welcome you and look forward to your speech today.
Ian Parton, Chancellor, Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, Stuart McCutcheon, Vice-Chancellor, university staff and students, but most importantly, graduands and your families, ladies and gentlemen and children, tēnā koutou. For me, it is a great privilege to speak at your graduation ceremony and for many of you graduating to deliver the closing words of this chapter of your lives. As the Chancellor has said, more than 40 years ago, I also graduated from the University of Auckland with a bachelor's law degree. I had studied mostly part-time as a law clerk, attending lectures early mornings and evenings, and with the benefit of hindsight, I did not apply myself to my studies as much as I ought to have. However, I am glad to report, and I apply for a tick, respectfully, Chancellor, that the association I forged with the university during 5 years as a student has managed to remain a part of my life ever since. And I hope that you, graduating today, will have something of a similar experience. The degree you will bear in a few minutes from now in architecture, dance studies, fine arts, music, performing arts, planning, visual arts, urban design, or law will represent your achievement of a high standard of scholarship and your membership of a strong and enduring network. The support I have gained from this network in my personal and professional life through fellow students, lecturers, and mentors is immense. Do not discount the possibilities of this resource or think that it will not continue to grow after you have finished your formal term at university. Please let graduation not be the end of your connection. I hope that many of you will see the benefits of giving back to an institution which has given you its best. I congratulate you warmly on your success today. Your degree represents the culmination of focused and determined effort towards a goal, but it is also a key to further possibilities and new goals. It is appropriate to acknowledge the sacrifice and investment of your time and your effort, but alongside to mention in equal measure the support of partners, parents and families, as well as teachers and tutors. These people can also share pride in your achievement. The value of the education this university has provided is not so much in the ability that you have acquired to recall specific pieces of information, but is in the skills you have acquired to comprehend and hopefully solve some of the multi-layered issues that will confront you in our increasingly complex world. Today's graduates and citizens are linked by technology to the entire planet and its people. And never before has the universality of knowledge been so apparent or so important. Your education has enabled you to use the tools of critical thinking and reasoning, and you now have the ability to apply them. To lawyers, it may be in practice, but also to the problems of peace and security, and the idea that justice is something that belongs to all human beings. You who graduate today are among the privileged, and I hope that you will accept that with privilege come obligations. The knowledge and skills which your professors, lecturers and tutors, your families and you yourself have worked so hard at during your studies can now at last be applied, and the real work can begin. Before you do, though, the last ingredient to add is motivation. Whatever your field of knowledge, when your motivation is not merely for the betterment of you yourself alone, but for your family, your community, your country, and the world we live in, you cannot help but bring about positive change. Graduates of this university have succeeded in many parts of the world, furthered human knowledge in an exciting range of academic fields, and have become leaders in professions, science, industry, government, and society. Many have gone on to teach and thereby transmit and expand what they learned to a new generation. In closing, Chancellor, I would like to quote two people. First, the champion New Zealand motor racing driver, the late Bruce McLaren, who once said, "It would be a waste of life to do nothing with one's ability, for life is measured in achievement, not in years alone." Secondly, the legendary Steve Jobs of Apple, who died in 2011 after a lengthy illness. Jobs once said as follows, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. and most importantly, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary. That, with respect, seems a suitable note on which to end, and to wish each of you, ladies and gentlemen, well in the future. Kia kaha.
Thank you, Sir Anand, for a challenging and insightful speech. Can you join with me once more in welcoming Sir Anand? This is a meeting of council and convocation of the university at which the Pro-Chancellor, Peter Kiley, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries, Professor Brand, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries. Graduate Diploma in Music, Srinivasan Tirumanga Lakudi Natarajan. To the degree of Bachelor of Architectural Studies, Eric Franco Maria Abba. Rasha Al Asafi. Shrija Bazak. Sophie Elizabeth Dion Violetti. Joanna Lisa Kate Bolland. Bahador Borani. Gemma Claire Bradley. William Daniel James Brooks. Taylor Chan. Mirashini Chandra Mohan. Han Chen. Haorong Chen. Lin Bing Chen. Sihan Chen. Carlock Chin. Robert Johannes Cunnilison. Lisa Ann Curtin. Nicole Cherie Dorr. Archit Dingra. Kyle Calvin Mello. Charlotte Louise Farquharson. Yu Ming Feng. Amy Michelle Flett. Bernadette Chu Wing Deverell. Senior Scholar, Creative Arts and Industries, Christopher Allen Ford. Senior Scholar, Creative Arts and Industries, Tessa Elizabeth Ford. Gabrielle Kate Hanna. Nathan Andrew Hayes. Xiang He. Yiheng He. Aaron Cavill Hills. Sally Jupinen Hosking. Bennett James Hume. Yiheng Zhong. Chirag Jindal. Nicholas Rob Johnston. Ji Min Jun. Joseph Evrel Consumido Kagawan. Amrita Cole. Erica Claire Kenny. Hyun Min Kim. Wewe Kong. Grace Yi Kung. Joyce Kwong. Donna Lee. Sung Hoon Lee. Zi Yan Grace Leung. Shang Li. Vanessa Zi K. Leo. Zi Yi Leo. Zhang Shung Ma. Emma Catherine Mannion. Young Ming. Sukshma Sri Krishna Paranjape. Sean Kibum Park. Samuel Jonathan Peters. Vasilije Rekovic. Eve Louise Roberts. Rachel Ann Piper. Matthew Kyun Jiryu. Yukong Shan. Annabelle Laura Standage. Marina Stojanovic. Alexander James Sullivan Brown. Yining Tan. Campbell John Taylor, Samuel Robert Thompson, Aidan John Thornhill, Jack Tiong, Louis Tong, Stacey Ann Vallis, Lee Wong, Sulin Wong, Amelia Rose Watkinson, Malia Tanya Jolin Ta'aipu Leono Isalafai West, Alfred William Wigmore, Samuel Junjie Wong, Hui Ching Yu Wu, Paul Yun, Yu Chen Zhou, to the degree of Bachelor of Dance Studies, Kaya Jill Delphin Campy. Nicola Alice May Dowling. Helen Ruby Foy. Jamie Elaine Green. Michelle Caitlin Hale. Sophie Jean Harvey. Melissa Louise James. Jessica Audrey Anna Rose Paris. Livia Kate Pierce. Camille Claire Pink. Richenda Chantal Sheldon. Caitlin Alexandra Smythe. Nikki Alexandra Stillwell. Senior Scholar, Creative Arts and Industries, Hannah Catherine Thompson. Alexandria Renee Tunter. Kimberly Kylie Young. Sophia Kipriano Zinu. To the degree of Bachelor of Fine Arts, Eva Jean Burgess. Josephine Hannah Coyle. Claire Elizabeth Cudmore-Neem. Cordell Alia Foe. Stephanie May Fourie. Georgia Caitlin Gillings. Peter Kim. William Taiwan Kim. Ashley Koo, Kayung Lee, Atapana David Malaysia, Kendall Amy Mustard, Ha Yun Park, Renee Laura Pennington, Laura Ann Claire Putnam, Rosanna Grace Smith, Joseph Christopher Waddingham, Corey Tammy Whiteley, to the degree of Bachelor of Music, Ang Chu Zi, Chus Kuchis Meafo Ave, Ezra San Felipe Umuariki Tikani Bartlett, Hannah Gillian Brewer, Tenan James Burkhart, Clotilde Joelle Chapperson, Yingju Chen, Kai Shin Chong, Danielle Nicole Davies, Taunoa Philly Moe Hala, Meredith K. Hancock, Stevie Marie Hill, Annie Sun Jung Kim, Joon Kim, Yoon Kyung Kim, Chuk San Leung, Madeline Ashley Yu Hua Lee, Alicia Mary Lynham, Anna Elizabeth Loveys, Gustavo Ruben Nervenia, Madison April Cadon Nonoa Horsfield, Christina Jo Nutt, Emily Hannah Rice, Douglas Frederick Robertson, Adam Joseph Rudell, Michael Charles Shatke, Megan Louise Sidwell, Matthew David Christopher Sutton, Jacqueline Ella Tyler, Liam Kahukura Wooding. Cindy. Cindy Chen Shin Xia. Yong Kang Yu. Wei Yue Zong. To the degree of Bachelor of Performing Arts, Renee Elise Ball. To the degree of Bachelor of Planning with First Class Honours, Nathan Mark Kite. Michael Brian Tracy. Senior Scholar, Creative Arts and Industries, Liam Hansel Winter. To the degree of Bachelor of Planning with Second Class Honours First Division, Jared Manuel Colbert. Kelly Jean Durham. Samantha Claire Gibbs. Aaron James Gray. Charlotte Penelope Hamilton Palmer. Isabel Hand. Rakesh Richard Kumar. Ying Liu. Kerry Tihikarangi Parakofai. Anna Maureen Woodward. Yu Ching Zhou. To the degree of Bachelor of Planning with Second Class Honours Second Division, Georgia Ellen Brown. Elish Grace Helena Collins. Jessica Ann Esquilant. Rakhil Mariam Khan. Minju Lee. Craig Ian Matheson. Vaitaua Meri Ma'u'ala. Evelyn Elisa Neal. Grace Hoy Yan Ng. Jessica Chang Parulian. Sunit Patel. Sean Masaki Sterling. Jason Paul Van Niekerk. Sophie Vanessa Wilkinson. Zhong Yu Yan. To the degree of Bachelor of Planning, Sophie Elizabeth Elwood. Tammy Fa'afu. Yi Pang. Samantha Leanne Thomas. Xinyu Wong. To the degree of Bachelor of Visual Arts, Senior Scholar, Creative Arts and Industries, Louise Allison Andrew. Katie Marguerite Bright. Daniel Joseph Devoy. Kahutia Tirangi George Martin Fowler. Cara Ann Griffith. Zachary Van Hogen. Ashley Helen Kissick. Chung Hong Kwok. Katie Alice Lammercraft. Su Jong Lee. Jordan Tungane Masters. Diane Ku, Hawa Hafiza, Pegiran Abdwahab. Bonnie Matilda Price. Winston Evans Shacklock. Brittany Eloise Smart. Cherie Dawn Stone. Tyler Ross Wheaton. Shenglong Zong. To the degree of Bachelor of Music Conjoint, Sebastian Montgomery Christian Bennett and a Bachelor of Arts. Alexandra Noel McDonald Bull and a Bachelor of Commerce. Erina Ashley Johnson and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Creative Arts and Industries and Senior Scholar Science, Nelson Yung Sum Lam and a Bachelor of Science. Anya Sophia Lehman and a Bachelor of Science. Amy Fiona McLean and a Bachelor of Commerce. Angela Poon and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Arts, Sasha Jane Rasmussen and a Bachelor of Arts. Peter Edward Rudell and a Bachelor of Arts. Shinran Zhou and a Bachelor of Arts. Postgraduate Diploma in Creative and Performing Arts with Distinction, Kerry Ann Stanton in Dance Studies. Postgraduate Diploma in Fine Arts, Sung Hee Lee. To the Bachelor of Dance Studies Honours with First Class Honours, Pauline Francis Mariah Hiroti. Nicole Caroline Pereira. Sophie Chantel Aroha Williams, and a Bachelor of Dance Studies. To the degree of Bachelor of Dance Studies Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Caitlin Elizabeth Williams. Kimberly Alicia Young. To the degree of Bachelor of Dance Studies Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division, Salode Nita Latu. To the degree of Bachelor of Fine Arts Honours with First Class Honours, Ji Yun Do. Sione Manu Finau Faletau. Kara Alicia Knapp. Alexander Keith Laurie. Natasha Adelaide Matilla Smith. Ella Grace McPherson Newton. Stephen Park. Chloe Riddell. Bryn Mary Roberts. Senior Scholar, Creative Arts and Industries, Ruth Anna Stanton. Salome Ofa Tanuvasa. Senior Scholar, Creative Arts and Industries, Yoshiko Teraoka. Jack Andrew Tilson. To the degree of Fine Arts Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Alexandra Beatrice Marie Green. Alana Marisa Lopezi. Georgia Alexandra McGill Bannon. Glenn Andrew Lionel McMillan Otto. Phoebe Katharina Patcher. Ameria Lee Pihema Williams. Christopher Patrick Ryan. Justine Sing Ing Moon. Julia Carmel Skeef. Zachary Kenneth Steiner Fox. Amy Shinran Young. To the degree of Bachelor of Fine Arts Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division, Lucy Elizabeth Alcafolo. Catherine Eliza Yoasa. Minji Kim. Ki Yun Lee, Yong Kyu Lim, Grace Amelia Winifred O'Hara, Shahinda Ahmed Efat Abul El Fatu Solomon, Timothy Edward Vickers, to the degree of Bachelor of Music Honours with First Class Honours, Edward Kenneth Giffney in Classical Performance. Bridget Siwengo in Studio Pedagogy. Rachel Emily Grimwood in Classical Performance. Na Yong Ku in Classical Performance. Gemma Lee in Classical Performance. Imogen Ann Morris in Classical Performance. Hei Won Su in Classical Performance. University Graduate Scholar Ella Rose Tunnicliffe Glass in Musicology. To the degree of Bachelor of Music Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Sung Jun Cho in Jazz Performance and a Bachelor of Music. Barnaby Flavel Chitty in Composition. Oliver Francis Huang Shu in Composition. Ina Kim in Classical Performance. Maehing Kong in Classical Performance. Monique Christine Vossen in Classical Performance. To the degree of Bachelor of Music Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division, Samantha Sky Jones. Natasha Rose Port in Classical Performance and a Bachelor of Music.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Sylvia Jiang on piano will now perform Transcendental Etude No. 10 by Liszt. Sylvia, thank you very much for that fantastic performance. I'd also like to thank you personally for helping us today. Sylvia's played twice, once at very short notice, and we're indebted to you. So thank you very much. Could you all join me in thanking Sylvia? Thank you. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industry and Faculty of Law, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
The degree of Bachelor of Fine Arts Honours Conjoint with First Class Honours, Anna Joy Maxwell, and a Bachelor of Arts. Emily Joy Sang, and a Bachelor of Arts. Rosalie Grace Wells, and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Bachelor of Fine Arts Honours Conjoint with Second Class Honours First Division, Senior Scholar Arts, Katrina Jane Edwards, and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Bachelor of Fine Arts Honours Conjoint with Second Class Honours Second Division, Rebecca Jane Ward, and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Master of Architecture with Second Class Honours First Division, Ushi Wong in Sustainable Design. To the degree of Master of Architecture with Second Class Honours Second Division, Dina Nasir in Sustainable Design. To the degree of Master of Architecture, Martin Hunter Chant. To the degree of Master of Creative and Performing Arts with Second Class Honours First Division, Yefim Alexandrovich Biechniakov in Dance Studies. To the degree of Master of Creative and Performing Arts with Second Class Honours Second Division, Christina Mary Louise Horton in Dance Studies. Ivania Natalie Ann Premadiah Quinn Valian in Dance Studies. To the degree of Master of Fine Arts with First Class Honours, Garth DeForge, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Fine Arts with Merit. Andrew Morris Clifford. Aisha Melody Green. Natalie Faye Guy. Zoe Rose Rapley. To the degree of Master of Fine Arts or Second Class Honours First Division, J. Brent Hollows. Shannon J. Novak. Rick Stevenson Rarity Wilson, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Fine Arts. To the degree of Master of Fine Arts with Second Class Honours Second Division, Thomas Vichalutz. To the degree of Master of Music with First Class Honours, Andrew Kelevar Faliatua in Performance. Elizabeth Yuen Chi Lau in performance. Andrew Strawn McMillan in composition. To the degree of Master of Music with Second Class Honours, First Division, Brent Lyle Reed in performance. To the degree of Master of Planning Practice with Second Class Honours, First Division, Brad James Allen. To the degree of Master of Urban Design with First Class Honours, Carl Roy Luca. To the degree of Master of Urban Design with Second Class Honours, First Division, Sarah Meg Finlayson. To the degree of Master of Urban Design with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Bingru Khan. Harshal Wagel. To the degree of Master of Urban Planning with First Class Honours, Rania Priya Devi Kumar. To the degree of Master of Urban Planning with Second Class Honours, First Division, Megan Elizabeth Couture. Stephanie Lamb. Antonia Helena McLean. Patrick George Franklin Moss. Robert James Nairn. Imogen Sophie Reed. Kelly Margaret Slater. Anna Claire Solomon. Jun Tang. Dane Thomas Waring. To the degree of Master of Urban Planning with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Ghazala Zinat Ambreen. Karan Satish Chandra Bangara. And in absentia, those are the persons named in the official record who have qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma from the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries.
I now call upon the Dean of Law, Professor Stockley, to present the graduands in that faculty.
Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Law. To the degree of Bachelor of Laws, Grace Helen Alexander. Tanya Noamalinu Asa. Aileen Tupu Tanya Atiola. Alicia Suzanne Castle. Jodie Marie Day. Goan Terengi Ho Duff. Lisa Valmetu May Fox. Tom Arthur Gillies. Alexander James Goodwin. Yu Yuen Ho. Mark William Ibrahim Azik. Yun Min Jun. Newton Philip Arundel Fitiata Lambert. Simon John Whitley Lamborn. Pei Fin Lee. Akesa Elaine Motuliki. Ellen Tracy Reynolds. Wirimu Ashley Ricky Hana. Cameron Neil Rewa Roger. Myla Rutton. Kelvin Saren Lee. Nazli Schoje. Joel Vaughan Teshkoff. Mana Wai Aroha. Kaihika Tomonu. Graham Paul Timms. Alana Margaret Todd. Sally Messina Falailua T. Toilolo. Carlock One. Kathy Kingya Wen. Jong Wu One. G. Yuen Yang. To the degree of Bachelor of Laws, Conjoint, Jeffrey Max Andreas and a Bachelor of Commerce. Ben James Atwood and a Bachelor of Commerce. Laura Josephine Bacon and a Bachelor of Arts. Samantha Ann Beattie and a Bachelor of Arts. Cheryl Lee Bessie, Te Ranga Belk, and a Bachelor of Arts. Luke Timothy Benson, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jessica Olive Ann Walden Bevan, and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division in Engineering Science. Philip Richard Bradshaw and a Bachelor of Commerce. Peter John Bristow and a Bachelor of Arts. Simon Andrew Bunkle and a Bachelor of Commerce. Hugo Hampton Clark and a Bachelor of Arts. Lily Riddick Clark and a Bachelor of Arts. Yatu Choi and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sophie Victoria Curlett and a Bachelor of Arts. Eru Era Wiramu Davies and a Bachelor of Arts. Misha Jacobin Davis and a Bachelor of Arts. Jeremy Anthony Terence DeMello and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division in Mechanical Engineering. Ming Jing Dong and a Bachelor of Commerce. Kent Andrew Lewis Duffy and a Bachelor of Arts. Upashna Datt and a Bachelor of Commerce. Kimberly Rochelle Eccles and a Bachelor of Science. Natasha Indravardhan and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jorinda Sunita Engelbrecht and a Bachelor of Arts. Daniel James Ferguson and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alicia Jane Friedlander and a Bachelor of Commerce. Gayfri Ganushan and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar in Business and Economics, Vidya Sheshavali Gary Mella and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sarah Jane Gilkison and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alexandra Grace Madeline Godinay and a Bachelor of Science. Alice Rose Gordon and a Bachelor of Arts. Faisal Halabi and a Bachelor of Arts. Guy Nicholas Hallwright and a Bachelor of Commerce. Tara Nicole Horaki and a Bachelor of Arts. Matthew John Hawley and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jian Wei Hu and a Bachelor of Commerce. Rochelle Ellis Hill and a Bachelor of Commerce. Keith Suasami Arthur Hopkins and a Bachelor of Commerce. Reese John L. Howard and a Bachelor of Commerce. Shafin Ashiana Janif and a Bachelor of Arts. Pamita Chacharika Hamali J. Asinga and a Bachelor of Commerce. Akatu Ramona John and a Bachelor of Commerce. Helen Catherine Johnson and a Bachelor of Arts. Kirsty Patrice Jones and a Bachelor of Arts. Rosemary Grace Judd and a Bachelor of Arts. Amit Kumar Kalyam and a Bachelor of Commerce. Stephen Joseph Carl and a Bachelor of Commerce. Nicholas Alexander Philip Keane and a Bachelor of Commerce. Minuk Kim and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jasgot Singh Kohli and a Bachelor of Commerce. Yoshi Koyama and a Bachelor of Arts. Jessica Wee Lun and a Bachelor of Arts. Coral Mary Tautoa Linstead Panoa and a Bachelor of Arts. Jason Yat Hay Low and a Bachelor of Commerce. Simon Alexander Robert Lowe and a Bachelor of Commerce. Phoebe Rose Helen Mason and a Bachelor of Arts. Janan Namorni McLeod and a Bachelor of Arts. Mark Joseph Menzies and a Bachelor of Commerce. Tairina Francis Noon and a Bachelor of Arts. Sasha Renee Nori and a Bachelor of Arts. Kosane Obata and a Bachelor of Arts. Rachel Ong and a Bachelor of Commerce. Ihapera Isabella Paniora and a Bachelor of Arts. Edric Roy Lustre Prasquel and a Bachelor of Arts. Jennifer Lee Savoni Rhonda Pritchard and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar in Arts, Jeffrey Brian Renton and a Bachelor of Arts. Craig Thomas Robertson and a Bachelor of Arts. Mikhail Edward Rodericks and a Bachelor of Commerce. Shukti Sharma and a Bachelor of Arts. Jay Shen and a Bachelor of Commerce. Hannah Grace Nofoana Silata and a Bachelor of Commerce. Matthew Bradley Sims and a Bachelor of Science. Avijit Singh and a Bachelor of Arts. Alina Smirnova and a Bachelor of Commerce. Connell Gian Thompson and a Bachelor of Arts. Siorsi Aofia Tofi and a Bachelor of Arts. Maranti Putri Utami and a Bachelor of Commerce. Annabelle Jane Home Venning and a Bachelor of Arts. Tuakasi Vulangi and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jen Wan Wong and a Bachelor of Commerce. Catherine Gia Lin Wei and a Bachelor of Arts. Tony Shehan Wijay Tilaka and a Bachelor of Commerce. Victoria Kaurangi, Yvonne Lee Wilson, and a Bachelor of Arts. Wai Ming Wong and a Bachelor of Commerce. Si Chi Shi and a Bachelor of Arts. Jason Yong Jae Yang and a Bachelor of Commerce. Yao Chao Ji and a Bachelor of Property. To the degree of Bachelor of Laws, with honours, Nicholas David Foster Bond. Stuart James Daly. Senior Scholar in Law, Andrew Philip Duncalf. Nicole Emma Horton. Melinda Souza Jacob. Adam Sean Kelly. Naomi Ripika Kora. Adam William McDonald. Monique Ellen O'Donnell. Robin David Penny. Catherine Kingsbury Rendell. Christina Ashley Rosa Watt. To the degree of Bachelor of Laws with Honours, Conjoint. Benjamin James Alderton and a Bachelor of Arts. Rachel Elizabeth Bailey and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Christopher Lee Baker and a Bachelor of Commerce. Georgina Emily Rhoda Borowitz and a Bachelor of Commerce. Camille Fleur Butters and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar in Law and Senior Scholar in Science, Annie Elizabeth Chow and a Bachelor of Science. Paula Elizabeth Casey and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alice Chan and a Bachelor of Commerce. Rachel Jane Chappelle and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar in Business and Economics, Augustine Hon Hang Choi and a Bachelor of Commerce. Thomas Christopher Clark and a Bachelor of Arts. Amy Catherine Cunniff and a Bachelor of Arts. James Peter Timmins Dunahir and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar in Law, Anna Devadason and a Bachelor of Arts. Zoe Claire Elwood and a Bachelor of Arts. Hugo Samuel William Farmer and a Bachelor of Arts. Charlotte Emily Forster and a Bachelor of Arts. Hannah Mae Griffin and a Bachelor of Arts. Nathan Edwin Hanson-Thorpe, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Emma Aliatasi, C. Cecilia Hau-Uli, and a Bachelor of Arts. Emma Kimberly Harris, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Kate Alexandra Hayward, and a Bachelor of Arts. Arun Jain, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Yvonne Alexandra Lipsky, and a Bachelor of Arts. Stephen Gino Troy Marching, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alexander Robert McDuff, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alexander Francis McKenzie, and a Bachelor of Arts. Ken Taro Madsen, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Claire Francis McGeorge, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jason Charles Mitchell, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Todd James Morrissey, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Brooke Ruth Muggeridge, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sanya Nenadich, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jessica Aroha Hope Reed, and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar in Law and Senior Scholar in Arts, Robert Edmund Schultz, and a Bachelor of Arts. Luke Craig Sizer, and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar in Arts, Alison Tang, and a Bachelor of Arts. Philip P. Sone Tang, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Senior Scholar in Arts, Stephanie Margaret Thompson, and a Bachelor of Arts. Reese Thomas Van Stiprian Lucius, and a Bachelor of Science. Dana Ann Walker, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Rebecca Louise Walsh, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jerome William Lee Webby, and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Master of Laws with First Class Honours, Kim Joanne Elford in Public Law. University Graduate Scholar, Jude Reed Anthony in Corporate and Commercial Law. Dawn Scarlett Alexia Duncan in Corporate and Commercial Law. Michelle Elizabeth May Heath Young in Corporate and Commercial Law. Eugene Roud in Corporate and Commercial Law. Genevieve Hanavia. To the degree of Master of Laws with Second Class Honours, First Division. Mohammed Abdul Aziz A. Alwaidani in Corporate and Commercial Law. Aroha Kahira Jasmine Fletcher. Dale Leanne Takutimu in Environmental Law. Gagandeep Tangri in Corporate and Commercial Law. J. Anthony Elias Talsi in Public Law. Lena Tuani, Anna Wong, and International Law. To the degree of Master of Laws with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Roxana Carolina Alvarado Usechi in Corporate and Commercial Law. Bhavna Shavina Singh in Corporate and Commercial Law. And in absentia, those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma from the Faculty of Law.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you, after I've doffed, the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Lee Grant Beatty in Planning. Lee investigated whether district plans in Auckland achieve their intended urban planning outcomes in practice. His research found that the district plans evaluated were overly complex and, in the majority of cases, failed to provide the means to achieve intended outcomes. Andrew James Hall in Architecture. Andrew investigated the field of mechanical metamaterials to control sound and vibration. Using internal arrays of small resonators, he was able to engineer partition systems that successfully blocked low-frequency sound transmission, significantly reducing noise pollution. Andrew. Namita Ravindra Kambli in Urban Design. Namita investigated the influences of digital media on urban public places with a view to exploring the opportunities that these technologies offer for 21st century placemaking. Cara Ruth Marlene Rosemeyer in Architecture. Cara examined ventilation options for New Zealand homes and their impact on indoor environmental quality and affordability. To the degree of Doctor of Laws, Warren John Brookbanks. Warren's research and writing has been principally concerned with criminal law and psychiatry and the law and issues at the interface between these disciplines. His research has led to the co-authorship of leading textbooks on New Zealand criminal law and mental health law, and to the co-editorship of texts on criminal justice and psychiatry and law, often cited in New Zealand court decisions. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a doctoral degree in the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries and the Faculty of Law.
Teaching Excellence Awards. The university places considerable significance on excellence in teaching. It recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify a truly superior achievement. An award for sustained excellence in teaching has been made to Ms. Kylie Quince within the Faculty of Law. I call upon a student of that faculty, Jacob Spoonley, to read the citation for Ms. Quince.
Currently, a certain political philosophy holds sway over our academic endeavour. Consequently, academics, achievements and abilities are often reduced to a mere measuring of research outputs. The importance of teaching and the importance of interaction with students is increasingly overlooked. Kylie Quince, however, has stood steadfast in her commitment to excellence in teaching. From a student's point of view, the law and your responsibility to understand it can be daunting and has the potential to appear insurmountable. Kylie Quince slices through this illusion with wit, verve, energy, and aplomb, drawing on her Te Roro, Ngāpui, and Ngāti Porou heritage. In the classroom, she speaks effectively, directly, and unpatronisingly to all constituencies. Perhaps the defining feature of Kylie's teaching is her ability to encourage, rather than alienate, difference of opinion in both students and colleagues. She is unique in the way she can walk in multiple worlds, challenging assumptions made about biculturalism, while recognising New Zealand's multicultural realities. This is best exemplified by the fact that she is concurrently an enduring fan of the loyalty testing Liverpool Football Club, Vodafone Warriors, and New York Rangers. Where others compartmentalise their job, differentiating between the classroom and the office, Kylie adopts a genuine, holistic approach to teaching. She exemplifies the open door policy to the point where, at times, conversations, particularly about Doctor Who or Game of Thrones, can be heard across entire floors. Kylie is a strong advocate for students, helping them navigate their barriers to success while maintaining high levels of professionalism and integrity. She expertly combines high expectations with genuine and personal care. Finally, I wish to convey to you today that I'm not one student standing before you. I'm an individual representing the many. On behalf of David, Levi, Georgia, Ruby, all of your students and colleagues, those present and those not, I congratulate you and wish you all the best with your nomination for the National Award. Kia kaha whaia.
We are nearing the conclusion of the formal part of this ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. while you are standing, it would be a good time for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. This concludes this meeting of council and convocation of the university for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to stand and sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of the programme.